Let's continue with some fun and games. With playing cards. With higher and lower. Part A, the game. So let's play. Higher or lower than a queen? Let's say lower. Card is 2. 2 is lower than a queen. Well done. Higher or lower than the 2? Higher. Card is 9. 9 is higher than 2. Well done. So what about 9? Higher or lower than a 9? Lower. Card is 7. 7 is less than 9. Well done. So let's make a shuffled pack of cards. So we can choose a random card by using random. Random int we saw in the last video. But to play a normal game, we want to have a pack of cards, which is 52 cards, and then shuffle them. So we can use random.shuffle. Here's the code to get the cards. So we make a list from 1 to 52 and then we shuffle them. So we have a list of numbers between 1 and 52 that are in a random order. So there's 52 numbers and they are randomly shuffled. So what do we do now? Well, we're playing higher and lower, which is starts off lowest is 2 up to Jack, Queen, King, Ace. So we need to convert the number of 1 to 52 into a number we can play for higher or lower. And we also need to show, for example, if we have 11 as Jack, we can't show 11, we need to show the Jack, Queen, King or Ace. So how do we turn numbers 1 to 52 into the playing cards? Well, there's 4 suits. We don't really need to worry about the suit, if it's a heart or a spade or a diamond or a club. We just need to worry about the number. So to start off, the lowest number is number 1 and the lowest card is 2. We have 2, 3, 4 up to 10. So that would cover our numbers 1 to 9. And we've got Jack, Queen, King, Ace. 10, 11, 12, 13. So we've got 13 times by the 4 suits. So here we've got all of the playing cards and we've got numbers 1 to 52. We can put the numbers by all of the cards. Now, if we think about adding 13 at a time, we've actually got all the cards and numbers 1 to 13 4 times. Remember, in this game, the suit doesn't make any difference. So as long as we use the numbers 1 to 13, that's all we need. We can do that in 4 times for the suits. So essentially, for each suit, if we add 1 to the number, the lowest number is 1, we add 1 to get 2. We go all the way up to 9, add 1, we get to our 10. And then we've got Jack, Queen, King, Ace as numbers 10, 11, 12, 13. So we can work out our numbers 1 to 52, split them into 4, which is 1 to 13, and then change the 1 to 13 to the playing card. Okay, so we have numbers 1 to 52. We can change that to 0 to 12 using modulo. So if we use the percentage sign and 13, that will give us the difference when we divide by 13, the remainder. So 13 modulo 13 will give us 0. 25 modulo 13 will give us 12. 26 modulo 13 give us 0. So our numbers 1 to 52 are now 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 12. So we've got 1 to 12, but the highest number, like 13, 26, 39 and 52, are now 0. We add 1 to each number, so now 1 to 12 becomes 2 to 13, but our 0, which is now 1, was the highest. So we're going to change that 1 to 14. So we add 1 to our answer from the modulo, the remainder. So now when we have 2, we want that to equal the playing card 2, and the 10 will equal the playing card 10. 11 will be a jack, 13 will be a king, 12 will be a queen, and ace is high. So ace, which is 1, we need to change that to 14 to make the number 14 higher than the other numbers. Remember, when we're looking at two playing cards, all we need to know is if the number is higher or lower. So let's play higher or lower. Remember, we're comparing two cards, the numbers from 1 to 52. So the playing cards are from 2 to 10, and jack, queen, king and ace. The suit doesn't matter. So it doesn't matter what the suit is, 5 will always be higher than 4. Here we've got the code. So the card, we have modulo 13 plus 1. If the card equals 1, make it equal 14. So that's the code that puts our numbers ready for comparing to be higher or lower. Now when we show the card, we're not going to say 11, 12, 13, 14. The user won't know what we mean. So we have to change 11 to a J for a jack, 12 to a Q for a queen, 13 for a K for a king, and 14 becomes ace. Let's have a look at some code. We're going to get some cards, the shuffle pack. We're going to print them, and then we're going to look at one card. So we're going to take a card out of the list, convert it from a 1 to 52 number to a 1 to 13, 14, and then print the card. We're going to do that in a for loop, so we do it 3 times. We can see that in our code we've got get the cards, that gives us our shuffled pack, convert, which gives us the numbers 1 to 52 to 1 to 14 or 2 to 14, and printed card, so we can see the jack, queen, king or ace. So let's have a look when we run this. So we have our list, our shuffle pack. We can see we take one card out. Here's 47. That converts to a 9. So here we've got our pack again, minus the 47. Take out the last card, 14. Converts to a 2. Take out our last number again, converts to a 7. So here we have our pack. We have one card. We can convert it to a number, and then we can print that as if it's a jack, queen, king or ace, for example. Let's run it again. So here we've got the last number is 13, which comes out as 14. Converted, which is an ace. So let's have a look at the game. Higher or lower than a queen? Lower. 2, well done. 2 is less than queen. Higher or lower than 2? Higher. The new card is 9. 9 is higher than 2. Higher or lower than 9? Lower. The new card is 7. 7 is lower than 9. Well done. Here we've got a similar game. But have a look, when the user didn't put in L or H, L for lower or H for higher, you need to put an error message in to remind them to put in L or H. Finally, here we've got higher or lower than a king. They've put in H for higher, and the card is 5. 5 is not higher than king, end of game. So you have to make sure that you check to see if the answer is correct, and if it's not correct, to end the game. Let's have a look what the code does. Here we've got numbers 1 to 52 and then they're shuffled. So here's an example with all the numbers shuffled in a list. Here we convert the card, and then we're going to show the card, and here we're comparing to see if the card is higher or lower than the previous card. So the last slide, we can see higher or lower. If we use the if else statements, we can see if it's correct or not correct. Let's have a look at the code. Here we've got the same code as we had before: convert card, print card, get cards. But now we have a function to play the cards. So this includes a message to the user to choose higher or lower, get the input from the user, make sure it is L or H, get a new card, print the card, and then see if it's higher or lower to see if it's correct. If it is correct, then we could try again with a new card. And we're going to try this with three cards. So let's run that. Hi, ready to play? Higher or lower than a 9? Let's say lower. New card is 8. 8 is less than 9. Well done. Higher or lower than an 8? What do you think? Higher? New card is 6. So end of game. Let's try it again. Higher or lower than a 4? Higher. Ace. Ace, we want lower than an ace. 9. Let's try lower than a 9 this time. 7. Well done. So we went through the 3 cards and got them all correct. Let's have a final look at the code. We started off with import random. So that gets our random when we choose our cards. So when we get cards, we can use the shuffle. So we've got a list of numbers from 1 to 52 and we shuffled them. Now we converted the 1 to 52 to a number from 0 to 13. 0 to 12, added 1 so it was 1 to 13, and then we changed 1 to 14 so it was effectively numbers 2 to 14, which was our playing cards. Then we changed numbers 11 to 14 to Jack, Queen, King, Ace. So when we run our program, we got the cards, we take one out, we change that to a number we can use to play higher or lower, and then we looped 3 times. And when we played, we showed the user a message, got H or L from them, error message if they didn't put H or L for higher or lower in. Then we get the answer and check against the new card to say the new card is either higher and it's correct, or lower or correct, or it's not correct. So we use an if else and an if else, both of them inside another if else. Thank you for watching, and if you haven't already, please subscribe.